As you say, halas.
Why would the father allow the
halas? It's finished.
No, you're not even thinking. Like, you're just
no, I am thinking.
A part of our conversation was like
a woman. Yeah, go on.
You have a chance. No, but if you're going to use emotion, I'm not going to use emotion. Yes, if we're here.
My friend, you know what you're using? You're a man. You're a man. You're not a woman. You're a grown man. Hang on. You're a grown man. You're not a child. You have never in your life experienced being penetrated, have you? Well, but you've never in your life. So think about what it's like being penetrated when your body is not ready for it.
I can't feel that.
Yeah, but that's your problem. Because you're not putting yourself in her position. You're putting yourself in the position of a man that's doing it.
The book says so.
Think about the woman, bro. Think about the child.
For example, in this day, there's some 9-year-old that is.
What? What was that?
I'm trying to say is, you say a body's a woman's body is very mature that it's dead, right?
There are so many of them.
There are people that are suicidal. You're living in a
bubble. He's living.
I don't
accept you.
Let me tell you something. I just showed you the headline. Yemeni child bride dies at the age of 8 due to internal injuries from a first night of marriage.
I'm saying that's
like, come on, bro. Of course it's wrong. Why are you defending this shit? I'm telling you, I'm emotional. A child died because she was penetrated too much by a grown man. And here you are telling me, oh, it's fine. It's wrong, but when your prophet did it, was it wrong? When your prophet did it, was she believed?
She died. Why did the prophet
so hang on? So a 9-year-old didn't believe.
The man, hold on. Everyone believes. I don't think that's sexual, but
does it keep it 100?
Why would the father consent? No, why would the father consent?
Because it's a fucking paedophile ring, that's why. Really? Yeah, it's a paedophile ring.
So you would have your daughter.
It's a paedophile ring. It's a paedophile ring.
I'd be chashing to your daughter.
Okay, if your best friend comes to you and says, hey, I've got a 6-year-old daughter. You know her, don't you? Marry her. So what are you going to say?
He
was considering marrying a 6-year-old girl.
That means you're a
potential child.
That means you're a potential.
Potential child molester here.
You're using the 2017.
Bro,
I told you. Why are you talking about something 4 years ago from 2017?
Because a 9-year-old, a 6-year-old is a 6-year-old.
I'm
thinking. A 6-year-old.
Hey. They might follow Gary Glitter soon, you know. In the future.
A six-year-old is a six-year-old.
Because he had good music. He liked little girls.
You don't have to go to Hong Kong.
Bangkok.
You don't have to go to Hong Kong.
To put yourself in the position of a 9-year-old child. Think about how it must feel though, just think about it.
I can't.
Even that's your problem.
Even if
you're not even trying to consider it.
For example, right? Say I was 9 and I didn't see pain, then what?
And then what? My man's so just
you're bringing stupid arguments.
He's trying to figure this out.
But you said, think about
you
it.
You don't feel pain.
If you don't think about it, it's not pain, right? Yeah, you're saying that every man has a penetration.
Crazy.
You're saying that every man has a penetration. You don't have sex with anyone. You're acting like everyone has the same size and you have.
So you're telling me Muhammad had a smooth dick. So Muhammad had a small dick. It wasn't a regular dick, but a smooth dick. That is. Like a finger.
You know what? You know one thing.
All right. Well, you take your small dick prophet over there. That's what you do. Take your small dick prophet over there and take him over there. I don't want to speak to you. About this shit. I ain't got time for anyone justifying this shit. I ain't got time to speak. Make it. Take it over there. Take him over there.
I told you.
Something you speak to.
I told you. Why are you going off this bullshit? I beg you, sign up on your own. You're going off this bullshit. It's because you don't know anything. speaks to an octet.
So he accuses him as well.
No, you listen to him.
Everybody else doesn't.
Oh, imagine his penis wasn't as big as it was. All of this stuff that you've got to go through just to justify this, bro. Like, all of this stuff, he had a small penis. Oh, he might have a small penis.
He changes like everything except this.
I think the base of it, why did no one cuss about this time?
Because they're all bloody child molesters, that's why.
So everyone thought they were
child molesters. If a man
lays there, you end up just.
If a man can come to you
for the rest of their lives
and ask you to marry him, there is a culture of that. It's a culture. Meaning it's not okay. Meaning it's okay amongst them.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, I don't live amongst them.
Okay, so contact him.
Of course I can.
Put yourself in their position.
Listen.
Put yourself in their position.
I can look. I'm not into your religion. I'm not into your religion.
Culture.
I'm not in your religion.
Culture.
Yes, and I have every right to critique it.
Yeah, exactly. But don't put yourself in that position. Then critique it.
I have a right to critique it.
I can critique it.
You're coming to me telling me that this system is the one for mankind, yeah? Islam is the one for mankind. I'm looking at your prophet and I'm like, to me, guys, like a child molester. Not for mankind, for me, bro.
For example, you're looking at one thing out of a million.
Yes, because you told me it's perfect. And that's not perfection to me.
And,
so if you're 100, you're 100. If you're 99, you're not perfect. The man 99 is not perfect. So you don't come to me.
You can't use your limited mind to try and...
Yeah, I can't use my limited mind. All right, fine. Well, your mind is limited. Mine isn't.
Everyone's limited. That's why you...
Sarah, you're going to get abused. That's what you're going to get.
No, you implied the prophet had a small dick. You implied it. I never implied that small dick. That was your little argument to try and get around the way you had sex with a girl. I never implied that small dick. You did. And I didn't imply it. I never implied that small dick. You
said that she felt pain.
You're saying every man's got the same size.
Yeah,
so it's okay. If he's a small dick man, it's okay.
He's got a little chipmunk today. Yeah, he's got a little something. Well, take your social dick prophet and be out of it. Take your social dick prophet and be out. Because I'm not having anyone, I've got children. You're not telling me that it's okay to do that. Just take him elsewhere, but I've got children. And no one, any man who thinks about doing that to my child is going to get fucked up. I'm telling you. I'm
going to
cut his dick off and I'm going to make him eat his own fucking dick. And I don't care. So don't come to me telling me that it's okay. I'm not listening to you. I'm not listening to you. Stop speaking to me. I'm not listening to you. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. It's finished. It's finished. You're trying to justify it to me. I don't want to hear it.
I'm not going to speak.
I told you how that's from before. Stop speaking to me.
I beg you, don't have a wrong standard. Don't go off his retro.
No, I'm not going
to. Okay, come on. So, yeah, I'm looking because you don't speak about it. You don't speak about it.
But you kept on speaking to me. I told you how that's. I told you finish.
I've given you all the reasons and you still put it aside.
Bro, you cannot reason it to me. That's what I'm telling you. Stop trying. Pointless.
Don't stop me.
Okay, thank you.